Please get ready for a dictation of exercise number 6 from legal material. 5 seconds. Start. The petitioner thereupon moved in this court for permission to produce before the court the original agreement bearing the signatures of the petitioner also. The said application was allowed on 21st May 2008. This court directed the respondent to file an affidavit clarifying its stand on the pleading of the petitioner of the agreement having been acted. The respondent thereafter filed an additional affidavit under section 340 of the CRPC. In the additional affidavit, while admitting the transactions with the petitioner, it is stated that the same were on the basis of invoices raised by the petitioner on the respondent and which did not contain an arbitration clause and contain clause regarding jurisdiction of Mumbai. The senior counsel for the respondent has urged that though the petitioner did not return the signed agreement, but the parties nevertheless proceeded to transact business. The application under section 340 of the CRPC has been filed on the ground that while the stand of the petitioner originally was that the copy of the agreement filed along with the petition was the only copy available with it, the signed copy having already been forwarded to the respondent, the petitioner forged the agreement subsequently filed and bearing the signatures of both the parties. The senior counsel for the respondent has argued on the same lines, though he had also sought to urge the aspect of limitation, but subsequently did not press the same, being a question of trial. By the present petition, the petitioner has sought recall of lookout circular and red corner notice issued by Delhi Police and Interpol against the petitioner, alleging that LOC and RCN were issued in arbitrary and malafide exercise of power by the respondent. The petitioner claimed that he was a Canadian citizen since January 2004 and a person of Indian origin. He had married one Miss Rima, daughter of Professor R. S. Mann, on 24th March 2002, according to Hindu rites and ceremonies at Infantry Hostel, Delhi Cantonment, New Delhi. At the time of his marriage, the petitioner was living and working in Canada and he came to India on 3 weeks leave for the purpose of marriage. The marriage was settled with Miss Rima through matrimonial advertisement in newspaper. The facts reveal that wife of the petitioner was not able to join the petitioner in Canada as difference arose between the parties in the very beginning. The petitioner alleged that he was compelled to withdraw the sponsorship made by him for his wife Reema in view of certain developments. A complaint against the petitioner and his parents and married sister was filed at Crime Against Women cell, making various allegations. Later on, an FIR was registered on the basis of this complaint. The parents and sister of petitioner obtained anticipatory bail from the court. Since petitioner was in Canada, he could not be arrested by the police. Additional Deputy Commissioner of Police wrote a letter dated 27th May 2003 to Foreigners Regional Registration Office for opening LOC against the petitioner. This letter, annexed with the petition, shows that additional DCP asked FRRO to open an LOC against the petitioner at All India basis because of FIR under Section 498A 406 of IPC registered at Police Station Alipur, Delhi. Later, a letter dated, letter seems to have also been written to Interpol Wing of Central Bureau of Investigation on 11th June 2003 for opening and issuance of a red corner notice and service of summons on the petitioner in Canada. In response to this letter, CBI wrote a letter to Dr. R. K. Bansal, ACP Subdivision Narela, New Delhi, and informed ACP that summons had been forwarded to Indian High Commission in Canada. Stop.